And Billionaire Charlie, man, back at it again, man. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button for me, man. Hit that like button for me, man. I appreciate everybody that tuned into my channel, man. You know what I'm saying? That we're getting this little bread, you know what I'm saying? You feel what I'm saying? But I seen this come past my little timeline on YouTube, man. And I say I want to talk about it, touch up on it, man. And this is the thing I always see within these young artists, man. Why was it YK or Osiris or something like that was saying that the music industry is evil, it's not of God, and things of that nature, man. And what normally happened is this guy jumped out the window telling the world that he's the best R&B singer when Chris Brown is the best R&B singer in the world. You know what I'm saying? Point blank period, man. And there's a lot of tears before it gets to Osiris. You know what I'm saying? I guess he got a little Def Jam deal or whatever the case may be. People know when you sign them contracts would come with that. They give you the advance money with the intentions that you're going to sell records and that you're going to have success within the business. Now, if you don't got hit maker or somebody helping you put the records together, you know what I'm saying, you might not have a lot of success. Because I always feel like when you're an R&B singer, you need a lot of good writers around you, good producers around you. And you have to take your craft seriously, man. You know what I'm saying? You can't just have a pretty face and then think you're going to sell records. You're not going to do that in this age and time, man. There's a lot that comes with this, man. People hating on the baby, saying a lot of his stuff is repeatedly, and he's not creative. I feel like he's very creative, and I feel like he goes outside the box with a lot of things he do with his videos and stuff like that. He's not a typical rapper. A typical rapper would have a Bentley or something like that in the video, a couple of girls dancing around. He kind of be creative with his videos and things of that nature. And he give you like multiple sides of comedy and things of that nature. When I see this young guy and he's saying, people saying it's of God and it's not of God and things of that nature. You know what I'm saying? When he's talking about the negativity that people are putting out into the community, I understand that point of what he's trying to say, but you can't discredit the fact that a lot of people that's been on the street that ain't have anything have an opportunity to feed their kids, feed their family. You know what I'm saying? So God would always want a person to be able to provide for his family. Now, it's up to you to be able to create a narrative to be able to sell the records and be able to do it within your righteous right. You know what I'm saying? And to be able to deliver it, you know what I'm saying, where people all over can receive it and they don't go against you as a person. You feel what I'm saying? So it's like, I don't think he should keep, you know what I mean, putting all this stuff out there because he ain't selling records or he ain't doing good. And he flopping. That's his point blank period. The man is not selling records, man. He's not doing good within the music business, man. Because they got, it's a bunch of R&B singers that sing. You got Jacquees, you got Trey Songz, you got so many different people that sing. So if you ain't got a hit maker or somebody behind you that's helping you put a couple of records together, then you're not going to sell no records, man. You know, man, anybody going to buy into it. You know what I'm saying? You might get a few girls that might like you, that want to come purchase a record here and there or get this and that. But your screaming numbers ain't going to really do nothing, man. And all these antics is going to make you look crazy. You know what I'm saying? Because you talking about an industry that you in. You know what I'm saying? So you saying all of that, but you going against what you think, what you believe as a man. And if you believe as a man that this is evil and it's not for you, and you talking about you want to get out of it, you know what I'm saying? Then my whole thing is this, man. You say you want to get out of it, then you say you got to do this to feed your family. Which one is it, man? They got Christian music situations that you can go do. You feel what I'm saying? So, like, come on, man. You're not selling, not doing good as an artist, and that's what it's all about, man. You're frustrated. Now, all you got to do is get in that laboratory, man, put your pen to that paper, find a couple of guys, hit makers, beats, and put it together and make it work. You know what I'm saying? People always think, bro, it's going to be easy. You're going to make music like Drake. Drake had to put in the hard work to become who he is today. Chris Brown had to put in the hard work to be who he is today. You know what I'm saying? Meek Mill had to put in the hard work to be who he is today. And me as a comedian and joking and having fun, I got to put in the hard work to be successful. And I'm willing to do that. And that's what these young kids got to understand, bro. Nothing come easy in this world, dog. You got to put the work in. You got to put the effort in. Point blank period, man. And don't worry about what people saying. Because you may fail one day. You fail tomorrow. But if you keep working hard on trying to be the greatest, then you're going to be that because you're putting your mindset into something positive. And that's all it's about, man, just being positive and not believing that. Don't allow the numbers to defer you to going crazy like this, you know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people was hurting in them streets, man. Everybody don't want to be robbing and selling drugs or doing things negative. The music business is how some people can feed their family, man. How they can get out of these streets and not be in these unpredictable situations where they doing life in the penitentiary just to get a couple of dollars, man. So, yeah, man, I don't think God ever want to see any of his people suffering in any form or fashion. Like I say, if you talking about drugs and all the other stuff, that's because you decided to talk about that. You feel what I'm saying? You can make a hit record not talking about none of that. But you know what I'm saying? But you believe in your mind that you can't make a hit record. Well, it's plenty of people that made hit. Come on, think about this, right? And I'm being real, man. Pharrell made a record about being happy. And it was a number one hit and everything. Happy. Come on now. Won't no drug dealing in there. Won't no fat butts. None of that. A record about being happy. He made plenty of records without no drug dealing or nothing in it. You gotta believe first before the world gonna believe it, man. You don't gotta make records like that. Man made a record about being happy. The joint was number one, all millions of sales. Come on, man. I don't even know the number on Happy, but I know pretty much that was a big record for real. No drug dealing in that. No big butts jumping around in that. You feel what I'm saying? So we can't make excuses for stupidity, man. If you want to make great records or you want to make records that make sense, do that. Who's stopping you from doing that? You know what I'm saying? So come on, man. You know what I'm saying? If you get some good producers behind you, good people behind you, put the records together, put the situation together, it's going to sell, it's going to do good. You know what I'm saying? But like I say, man, I'm making up all these excuses and saying this and saying that, trying to down the nets, man, this and that. Come on, man. You know what I'm saying? I don't believe God want to see none of his people suffer or see anybody going through trials and tribulations, man. Like I say, I don't believe promoting those type of negative images is what he want. But at the same time, we trying to get people into better situations so they can begin to bring positive messages out. But like I say, I just feel like this young man complaining. You know what I'm saying? He ain't doing good in sales. He jumped out the closet thinking he Jacquees. Talking about he the best R&B singer and all of that. Like, bro, you ain't even worked to even be mentioning that or saying that. That's the stupid thing about the young guys that's coming up. It's like, man, first, make your mark and begin to create. Don't even say that. Let the world say that. Chris Brown ain't got to say he the best ever because everybody see he the best ever. You know what I'm saying? It's like, who better than Chris Brown right now? Nobody. No R&B singer is better because he put in the work, he put in the effort. He even had downfalls with the Rihanna situation. But it took him to be a man to apologize for that and keep having a positive attitude even when everybody turned their back on him. You know what I'm saying? So it's no excuses, man. You got the deal, you got the advance money, go do the work, man. You know what I'm saying? It's the same thing that how what was the young kid, Rich the Kid, man. He had the same situation. Bro, y'all getting no contracts, man. Y'all getting enough money to be able to get y'all some lawyers and good people in the rooms, man. Once you may sign that first deal, may be a bad deal. Okay, we got it. We ain't had no lawyer, you ain't have none of that. Now you getting money. You need to have lawyers and everything in present when you signing them deals, man. Ain't no more trickery, man. You got to put your mind, you got to put your mind on this stuff. This ain't a game, man. You know what I'm saying? You coming out here saying all this stuff. You know what I'm saying? You got to have meaning and purpose behind it, man. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people feeding their family with this music stuff, man. But it's up to you. You can put your own stuff out. This is the thing Master P been saying for years, man. You don't need no label no more. This is the internet age. All you need is a distribution. That's it. You can make your own records. Just get a distribution, dog. Why is y'all signing deals in 2019, 2020? The fuck is you signing a deal for? Young Dolph and them rich. You don't gotta sign. Why people signing these deals? You don't even gotta do that. Once you got these hit records, you don't need to sign no deals no more. That's old, man. Master P and them already showed y'all the way. Master P, you know what I'm saying? Young Dolph, Gucci Man was doing it independent for a little while. You know what I'm saying? You don't really gotta do the deal thing no more. You can do your own thing. That's why people don't sign deals, especially when you're a creative person. It kind of stunt your growth because you got so many creative ideas that you're trying to do, and that kind of slow you up. So it's best not to sign a deal if you're going to be a creative person. You want to drop when you want to drop. You want to do the things creatively you want to do. you don't sign no deal. I'm saying, you could get show money, all of that. You build it yourself. You feel what I'm saying? If you so smart, like you say, that's what you do. You know what I'm saying? But that's all I got to say, man. Being that Charlie, man, I'm out of here, man. Young boy going crazy for no reason. You rich now. Go ahead and live your life, bro. You know what I'm saying? And just do the right thing, man. You feel me? I'm out of here.